I don't want you. thought I'd do.
Yeah.
Knock me down, but it's me. moments will be lost in time, like tears in rain.
From Tokyo to Los Angeles.
now, but it's going to be all right again. Take a stress pill and think things over. Take a stress pill and think things over. Take a stress pill and think things over.
Followers, but why we love this song so much is because it's about that moment in your life when you're just sort of semi-child, semi-adult, semi-something, where you're just sort of discovering the world, discovering what turns you on, what lights you up, what fills you up. And I guess what I think is important as you get older is that you have to remember all that. Otherwise you just sort of, I don't know, you just forget, and it's not good. It's good to remember that you can do anything you want, change anything you want. Any situation you might find yourself in today can be changed. It'll turn on the dime, believe me. Don't forget it. It's very important. This is why we love this song, and this is why we're going to sing it for you tonight. This is 13 by a band called Big Star.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. together. We'll go down forever. If we sleep together, would you let me better? If we sleep together, we'll let
we'll be right back.
forgive me. Thank you for your beautiful letter. It made me cry. Thank you so much. So we're going to play a song now that was a bizarre B-side back in the day. We wrote it really quickly, literally in like sort of two or three hours. We were forced into doing it at Rondor Studios in Los Angeles on La Cienega Boulevard. I remember it as though it was yesterday. And we wrote this song really quickly. We sent it off in a physical form like you did back in those days on an old school analog tape. We posted it. Well, it went FedEx anyway and it arrived and it came out a couple of weeks later. And we never ever thought about it again, but I think we performed it once. We played it once in London. Long, long time ago, in 2005, I think, was the last time we performed this song. And we've been playing it on our anniversary tour, this 20 years paranoid tour. And it's been a strange revelation. It's been a strange revelation for us, in a way, because, you know, you just don't listen to songs that you write, necessarily. We leave that to you, thank God. God bless you all. But we released a vinyl reissue, I guess, for the want of a better word, and it gets reviewed, you know, like anything you do as a musician gets reviewed. People like to tell you what they think, and that's fair enough, by the way. But this particular reviewer pointed out that this song had more meaning, I guess, than we initially imagined, and they pointed out this is a song about challenging the patriarchy, I guess. Understand, this is not a male bashing moment at all. I love men. I have worked my whole career with men. Some of the best things that's ever happened to me. I love you. I love men. But unfortunately, we're living in a period where women are under siege, not just here in America. I mean, if we think we've got it bad in America, let's just travel all over the world and maybe visit Poland or visit Brazil or Argentina. I really understand what it means to be a woman. Go to the Middle East. It's tough, man. So, I never in my wildest imagination ever thought that in America, women would be challenged in the way that we have been challenged recently. And there was a young woman in our meet and greet very recently who said to me, I feel totally defeated. Not only did it make me want to cry, but I could tell it really affected everybody in this band. We were really like taken aback at this young woman who is essentially talking about wanting to believe in her value and yet being told by the current administration that she means nothing, and it fucking really messed with me. And so this is a song for all the women here tonight, every single one of us. And it's also to all the good men in the audience who have our backs. And then white women, we also have to acknowledge that everything's just a little bit easier for us, or quite a bit easier for us, than black women and women of color. And it's about time we all start thinking of each other instead of just thinking about our own little sphere. Women are as popular as gentlemen. We have got to sort this out. So this is a song, as I said, that goes out to anyone who's feeling a little defeated by the pussy pitching and the complete denial of our existence in some cases. Love you all. I love anyone in this audience tonight who wants the best for women.
Don't be seen. Believe it.
self-centered and vain. You don't appreciate it. The world is the same, so I play the game. You're gonna hate me for it.
Thank you. When I was a kid, I thought I was. I can't believe I'm crying already. Sometimes I think people don't understand how lonely it is to be a kid. Like, you don't matter. You can't be ugly. Be pretty. It's weird.
Thank you.
relationship with DC since WHFS festivals. When we came to DC and we played that festival, we were like, holy shit, we're rock stars! Mid-afternoon, I think we had the 4 o'clock slot. I think No Doubt went on before us and Joe went on after us, or maybe it was the other way around. But it was an insane moment in all our lives. You know, you get to, I mean, I don't know, you get to fucking hang backstage with Gwen Stefani, are you kidding me? Like crazy, like the Beastie Boys, and I don't know, it was mad, right? It's just like a mad moment in alternative music where we all got to hang out together and play these mad festivals. And WHFS was just a big deal for us for many, many years. So we have not forgotten. And it just goes back even further than that. I was remembering playing here in the Black Cat with my band Angelfish. Angelfish being the band that got me my gig in Garbage. So, come on. But I remember being backstage. I mean, this was the first time I ever came to America. You've got to understand, it's so surreal and weird and mad. I came from this tiny island, and then I got here to the east coast of America, and we played the Black Cat. And I remember sitting in the dressing room seeing the biggest rat I have ever seen in my life. I'm not shitting you, it was that big. I was like, whoa, even the rats are bigger in America. Anyway, we've had a long love affair. Thank you so much. That has become a major sort of anthem for us, not just for us, but for our fans. We've received so many letters over the years talking about this song, and actually, we didn't come up with the title. The title was a Scottish author called Janice Galloway. And I remember reading that, well, I remember, read the book, and then I was like, that is an amazing title. I'm gonna steal it. And then I had to ask her permission, obviously, because I'm a lady and that's what you do. And anyway, she so gallantly gave us her permission to use this incredible title, and this is a song that we wrote that has stuck with us throughout our entire career. It's lasted 20 years and I'm sure it'll go on. And it's for anyone tonight who's feeling a little blue, feeling a little defeated. It's all right, things will turn around. same time, they then begged me, like, don't play androgyny, we don't know how to play it. So I'm not going to make them play androgyny. You should see Rita's face right now. He's like, Jesus fucking Christ, just tell us what it is. Okay, here's the audible voice, because I want to play the last song because of this week. So the audible's right now. The audible is, ladies and gentlemen, number one crush, motherfuckers. It can happen, bitches.
Thank you.
already. That's the great thing about having a microphone. But maybe I'll ask somebody just for kicks. Because I can always say, you, young lady. Yes, you. Yes, you. Uh-huh. In a gold sweatshirt. Come close to me. I won't bite. Well, sometimes I do, but you'll like it. All right, if you had your druthers, and you got to pick a song that we play next.
Do it right!
As our farewell song to DC for 2018. What would it be? Whoa! You know what? The gods have spoken. So here's the thing, that was on our set list anyway. And I feel like I didn't want to change cherry lips, and here's why. This has been a ghastly week for the LGBTQIA community. When a government comes out and says that it's no longer going to recognise transgender peoples, I take great offence at that. Because that is an archaic idea of gender. Gender is not binary. I think we all know that by now. I'm sorry, but I've got bigger balls than most of the men in this audience. It's just a fact, guys. It's just a fact. And also, a lot of my band who are men have got much more compassion and kindness and sweetness in them, and like traditional sort of attributes that are give, like sort of somehow associated with being a woman. So my point being is, I think in 2018 we all have started to grapple with the fact that binary gender that we were taught, I mean at least us lot, some of you are very young and perhaps it's different for you, but when we were growing up in the 60s and 70s, we were just taught that it was like you're either a boy or a girl. And I think we all know that's a load of fucking bullshit. So we are currently fighting for our transgender community. And we feel very strongly about it. So we are going to play Cherry Lips tonight, and here's why. This was a song that was written about transgender, about breaking down these binary codes that we all have to live by. Guys, I'm just saying, it's actually great for you because it means you don't have to be manly 100% of the time. And girls, we can fucking sway our balls. Let's get down with it. It's party time, motherfuckers. And this is Cherry Lips. We love you, DC. Forever and always, thank you so much. She gave you everything she had. She was young and dumb, she just turned 21. She didn't care who had her around. When the shit came down, why she was going to be found. That's like the turn of the girl back. She was the sweetest thing that you had ever seen. You're such a dead. Such a body was for real. It seemed like rain.